Well, praise the Lord. A very pleasant Thursday evening to you, and greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Thank you for joining me. My name is Ved Nukai. This afternoon, we come to the last phrase of the Lord's Prayer. As you know, for the past 2 weeks, we have been looking at the Lord's Prayer. So we have come to the end of this prayer with what is called the doxology, which is like a short hymn, and it goes like this, and found in Matthew chapter 6 and verse 13. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. If we are mindful of what that phrase means, we are going to have and going to be better equipped and prepared and ready for the day's challenges, for whatever might come in the afternoon, and for your night rest. And that is because this phrase tells us about three incredibly encouraging truths. Number one, it says or implies that God is in control. Yes, God is in control. Think about it. God created everything and all. Sorry, and it is all His. He owns it. He operates it. And any glory that is involved certainly belongs to Him. It is His domain. It is His territory. The whole realm belongs to Him. We can go anytime to visit or to spend a longer while, time to live perhaps, as long as we respect Him as the head of state. For it is the Lord that made the heavens and the earth for us. So then it says, and the power. Again, it is given that all power to do anything originates in the Lord. All power comes from Him. And yet, He gives us a measure of this power. Now, the word power carries two main thoughts. One, it carries a sense of ability or force, as we see in Matthew chapter 24 and verse 30, when it tells us that Jesus would be seen coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. Amen. The second meaning that it carries is it has more the sense of privilege and authority. And it is used at the end of Matthew where it says that He has power to forgive sin. He says, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. So all power belongs to Him. Amen. Employees, nations, governments wield great power. Their authority may be God-ordained, yet limited. Only God's power is unlimited. And He is ultimately in control. Absolute control, I dare say. Proverbs chapter 21 and verse 1 tells us that the heart of the king is in the hand of the Lord, and he can turn it whithersoever he wishes. Now here's a thought, that if enough of us, enough Christian people, enough God-fearing people, enough of us pray, there can be changes in the nations, in the world, in situations, in lives, in businesses, etc. 2 Chronicles chapter 7 and verse 14 tells us, if my people will pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, I will hear from heaven and forgive their sins and heal their land. 2 Chronicles chapter 7 and verse 14. Amen. But when we pray, yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. What we are praying, what we are saying is that, Lord, I am saying, God, you are number one. You are in control. And when I remind you, when we are cognizant of this, when we are mindful of this, when we remember that God is in control, it helps us by allowing us to remain calm, even in the face of serious temptations. And it helps us to relieve the tension of being compelled by any personal obsession that we may have to do what we know we should not do. So that is an important point, to know that God is in control. The second thing is that we understand from that phrase is that regardless of however the situation might be, favorable or unfavorable, whether we are at a passing situation or a changing scene in our lives, in the end we know that God will win and all who belong to him will win. Hear what the Bible says in the last chapter of the book. It says that God wins in the end. No matter how big the army against God is, he will always win. It does not matter how difficult an adverse a situation or circumstance or condition might be, we know that in the end, God will win. Revelation chapter 20 verses 8 and 9 tells us, and will go out to deceive the nations which are in the four corners of the earth, Gog and Magog, to gather them together to battle, whose number is as the sand of the sea. They went up on the breadth of the earth and surrounded the camp of the saints of the beloved city. And fire came down from God out of heaven and devoured them. So the enemy could mount all kind of challenges. The enemy can launch a myriad of attacks against the people of God and even God himself. But in the end, God wins. So hear this, my dear friend. Don't be depressed with all of the bad news. Or if things are not in your favor at this point, know for a fact that God wins. As somebody's rightly said, if you look at the world, you will be distressed. But if you look within, you will be depressed. But if you look at Christ, you will be at rest. I believe is that Jewish woman, Corrie ten Boom, who said that if you look at the world, you will be distressed. If you look within, you will be depressed. But if you look at Christ, you will be at rest. Hallelujah. Therefore, it depends on who you are looking at. Won't you agree? Amen. I'm hearing you. You're giving me a good amen. Hallelujah. So we continue. Yours is the kingdom. Yours is the power, yours is the glory forever, forever. Bear this in mind, my friend, that this is from day to day, but not only is it from day to day, not only victory belongs to us on a daily basis, but it is also for eternity. Amen. Hallelujah. And the third encouraging truth that we can draw from this phrase is the last word of the phrase, which is amen. You remember the phrase, thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Now that word amen is pronounced by some as amen, and by others like yours truly as amen. It really does not matter. You could say amen if you want. I could say amen also. We can have a different pronunciation. The thing is, we will all go to heaven. It wouldn't keep you back from going to heaven, nor would it keep me back from going to heaven. You agree with me? Amen or amen. Now, amen or amen means yes. Simply put, it means yes. So, in the Lord's Prayer, we make many requests. You will recall over the past 2 weeks that we have been making the requests, as He invited us to do. And these requests are vital requests. We pray that we would live and bring honor to the name of the Lord. We pray in that prayer, in the Lord's Prayer, that our lives would be God's kingdom, where God is present and where He rules. Remember, you remember, thy will be done, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Yes, we pray that God's will be done in us and through us. We also prayed that God will provide for us, give us this day our daily bread. We also prayed that God will forgive us and give us the will and the ability to forgive others. When we prayed, forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who have trespassed against us. And we have also prayed in that prayer that God will protect us from temptation and deliver us from the evil one. We did that on Monday. Amen. And to each one of these requests, we have said at the end, amen or amen. What we have been saying, what we really mean, is that when we say amen, we mean yes, yes, it will be done. Hallelujah to the Lamb. So we pray the Lord's Prayer. We pray it with confidence. We pray it with the assurance that God will answer us. Hallelujah. And when we end the prayer, amen, we say amen. In saying amen, we are not asking ourselves questions like, I wonder if God heard my prayer. We are not asking questions like, I wonder if I prayed for what God wanted me to pray for. We prayed it with confidence. That is what he said to pray. Hallelujah. We don't end the prayer, hallelujah, by saying, I wonder if God really heard me. No, no, sir, no, ma'am, no, brother, no, sister, no, hallelujah. We do not end the prayer with questions like, I wonder if God will answer my prayer. No, sorry, we end the prayer with an amen or amen, if you choose. Hallelujah. Amen. We are saying, God will answer our prayer. God will answer our prayer. God will answer our prayer, not because of who we are, but because of who he is. He has given us this model prayer. He has given us this way how to pray. And therefore, we are praying according to his will when we follow the Lord's prayer. Amen. I want to close in telling you this evening that the Lord's prayer is a powerful prayer. It is a life transforming prayer. Hallelujah. And when we pray it sincerely, when we pray it from our hearts, when we pray it from the depths of our souls and our spirits, hallelujah, I tell you, my dear friend, it will allow us to remain calm in the face, amen, of serious temptations, hallelujah, and it will reveal us from any compulsion that we have of personal obsession, which we know that we should not do, hallelujah. It is a prayer that God has given us. It is a model prayer that he intends for us to use, hallelujah. Yes, I know that there are other inspired, Holy Ghost inspired prayer found in the New Testament, like in Ephesians chapter 1, for example, but those prayers do not contradict the Lord's prayer. On the contrary, they are really a fulfillment of this basis prayer or this foundational prayer. Hallelujah to the Lamb. So my dear friend, I encourage you, God wants us to pray. He wants us, when we come to him, our approach be the right one. We approach him reverently. We approach him, amen, and honor him. We approach him, hallelujah, telling him that we love him and we recognize that he is God and he alone is God. And then we lay all our requests before his feet. And then we close, hallelujah, with the doxology in which we really give him praise. I just want you to notice one thing. That there is in that same verse, when he is saying, deliver us from lead us out of all temptation and deliver us from the evil one. Hallelujah. The next phrase in the same verse is this. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. What a contrast and a contradiction. But it is given to show us that God triumph over evil. God triumph over his arch rival. God triumph over the work of the adversary. He is God, hallelujah, all by himself. He is God. He and he alone is God. Let us follow him. Amen. Let us be faithful to him. Let us love him. And let us live a submissive and committed life. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Amen. Let us pray this evening. Lord, we give you glory. Lord, we give you thanks. We honor you. To God be the glory, great things he has done. So loved he this world that he gave us his son, who yielded his life as an atonement for sins and opened the life gate that all may go in. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord. Let the heavens rejoice. Oh, come to the Father through Jesus the Son and give God all the glory, great things he has done. Father God, we thank you for giving us a foundational and model prayer, which, oh God, we can adopt, and you will expect us, since you have given it, that we will adopt it and make it personal in our lives. Hallelujah. And I pray, Lord, together with my rest of brothers and sisters, hallelujah, that are joining right now in this prayer, brethren from the Aruka Worship Center and others from other churches and assemblies, oh God, and those across the shores, oh God, those that are following us all the way, oh God, as far as India and Nigeria, hallelujah, to the Lamb, and coming, oh God, closer down here to the West, oh God, in the United States, in Georgia, oh God, and those that are joining us in Fort Lauderdale and in New York and right here in the Caribbean and in Trinidad. I pray for my brothers. I pray for my sisters. May the power of the living resurrected Christ touch them right where they are. There are those that are needy, meet their needs. There are those that need a revival. I pray, Lord, that you will revive us again. Fill our hearts with your love and may soul be rekindled with fire from above. Hallelujah, thine the glory. Hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, thine the glory. Lord, revive us again. Revive the church again. Revive your people again. Revive us, O God, near and far. Revive us again. Hallelujah. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, bless all of your dear children in Jesus' name. Father, we commit ourselves the best we know how to unto you in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Dear friends, thank you for staying with me this afternoon. This has been Words of Encouragement with me, your friend, your brother, Ved Nokai, from the Aruka Worship Center, situated at Lower Railway Road in Aruka. I thank you for joining us. I thank you. I cannot say how much I love you and how much we love you. We're praying for you. We are on every afternoon at 6 p.m. on the same platform, Aruka Worship Center, live on our Facebook page. Please join us. Join us tomorrow again when a group of us will gather for prayer. God bless you. Have a wonderful night. I love you. In Jesus' name. Amen.